If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out.
She isn't real, but she can still sell your product. In this video, we're going to make TikTok-style ads with AI UGC creators just like this one.
Guys, this is literally my emotional support animal.
Yerba mate is getting a lot of props right now, and for good.
Guys, this is probably the best banana I've ever tasted, and trust me, I know bananas.
Normally, e-commerce brands can spend up to $200, $300, or $400 for a single UGC video like this. With the AI tools I'm going to share, you can make ads like this for less than 1/10 of that cost. And now with AI, you can spin up customized variations with different characters, outfits, and angles, so you can A/B test and find the best performing ads to save on more cost. Here's what we'll cover. We'll write effective scripts that actually convert. And then we'll generate AI actors that match your ideal customer profile. And then we'll animate everything with realistic lip sync. And finally, we'll edit the video in a TikTok-ready format. By the end of this video, you'll have a repeatable and affordable system for producing UGC ads that convert. Let's break it down step by step. UGC stands for user-generated content. UGC ads work because they feel conversational, unlike polished brand content. AI maintains that casual feel while giving you complete control and unlimited testing capabilities. Before we jump into creating, here's something most people get wrong. They skip the research phase and wonder why their ads don't convert. The difference between ad that converts and one that doesn't often comes down to understanding what's already working in your niche. First, let's look for some inspiration online. If you want to model advertising style video, a great place to start is the Meta Ad Library. There you can filter by niche and see the types of ads other brands are running on Facebook or Meta. If you want something more TikTok friendly, we can use the TikTok Creative Center. You can find real ads that people are running for products similar to yours. For organic style content, we can go directly to TikTok. In the Explore page, search your niche and filter by engagement and analyze what high performing videos are doing. And pay close attention to the first 3 to 5 seconds. That's where you either hook viewers or lose them forever. When it comes to writing the script, I prepare a prompt template for TikTok style ads you can use. It's structured for UGC ads in the first person point of view, and it follows the AIDA frameworks that copywriters use for high converting copy. I've also mixed in some other best practices from successful UGC campaigns. All you need to do here is to fill in your product details. We can also put in a hook we prefer that we probably see on other people's video in here. And then we drop the prompt into ChatGPT or Claude or any other LLM you prefer, and let it generate script ideas. Most likely, you'll usually need to adjust the first line or hook. If that doesn't work, nothing else matters. And it's really hard for ChatGPT to get it right. Here's the script we generated and refined for this example. Next, we'll use this as our base and move on to generate the voice. The voice is what separates believable UGC from obvious AI. It's often the first giveaway that kills trust and conversions. The voice definitely need to sound natural and conversational, like a friend recommending something, not a sales pitch read by robot. That's why I use 11 Labs, because you can create custom voices that match your exact audience. Instead of picking from their library, I wanted to design a voice myself. To create your own custom voice, you only need their free plan. First, let's go to the voice section, hit the plus sign or the create voice button. Then here we click voice design, and then we paste in our prompt, and this is the prompt that I use. We can also adjust more settings down here, and then we generate. Then we'll get multiple options to choose from. Let's listen and see what we get.
So I just had to share this with you all. I finally tried that new coffee shop downtown, and oh my gosh, it's amazing. Seriously, you have to check it out. Hey everyone. So I had to share this with you. Finally tried that new coffee shop downtown, and oh my gosh, it's amazing. So I just had to share this with you all. I finally tried that new coffee shop downtown, and oh my gosh, it's amazing.
I'm so surprised how real they sound. It really sounds like a Gen Z TikTok influencer talking to you. Then we will just select the voice we prefer, fill in the name and the details to tag the voice for future reference, and then we can save the voice. Once you have your voice, let's go to text to speech, select the voice that we just generated, and then we paste our script here. and generate. Then we can listen to the generated voice.
If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out. If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out.
Download the file we prefer for the next step. Now we're getting into the visual part. The influencer's look is also very important. It needs to feel realistic and also relatable to pass as authentic UGC content. For this, we are using DeSign AI. I'll start by generating an influencer using the text-to-image tool on DeSign. After testing multiple different models, I found that DeSign's realistic models actually works best for that homemade and non-studio look that we're looking for. Other than selecting the model, the key is also to include specific details about imperfections in your prompt, like this one. In my prompt, I included things like her skin has a hyper-realistic texture, showcasing subtle imperfections like light pores and slight unevenness with a natural shine. You want realistic results and not perfect. You can also customize the influencer's demographic and overall look to match your target audience. And I made sure to prompt for an ordinary background, something simple and natural. You don't want a polished studio setting. That way, the result feels casual and authentic, just like real user-generated content. We can select the prompt improver, select the proper aspect ratio. Since we're doing TikTok, then it would be 9:16. And also, if you have an influencer, you really want your influencer to be a certain face, we can also use the face match feature to input the face so that the generated result will match the face. And then we'll do non-explicit, unless you want to generate not safe for work content. And for generation mode, I always select high quality for best result. And then we'll click generate to generate the result. And here's the results. The influencers we generate here are pretty natural, I would say, and realistic to me. You can see the unevenness and the skin texture that is trying to mimic human imperfection. Compared with the images I generated from other models, I do really think the DeSign Realistic is the best model to generate this. Next, we will need to put the product that I have in her hands. And I already generated this product image. And in DeSign, there are two ways to do this. One way is using the instant storyboard. This lets you combine different elements into the same image. You'll just have to upload both the influencer image and the product image. And then in your prompt, reference them with the ad tag. So in general, add image one, when you type in the ad, the image will jump out and then you can just click to load it in, or you can just click on image one and it will get put in the prompt. So in this case, image one would be referring to the influencer or that image, and image two would be the product. So for example, you can write something like image one is holding image two in the same setting and background. Something simple like this. And the AI should be able to understand. I have prepared a more detailed prompt here. And then we just have to put in the ad tag for the AI to know what we are referring to. Once that's set, we can choose the highest output quality and set the aspect ratio to 9:16, which is the vertical short form content format. And here's the result. I think this one came out perfect. Another thing we can do here is using the chat editor feature. So first we click on the influencer's image and then click chat editor. The influencer image will be loaded and then we'll just have to add the product image using the plus sign on the right to also input the product image. DeSign now have added the Gemini 2.5 Flash model, also codenamed Nano Banana, which is Google's latest AI model that's been called the best image editing models available. Well, at least for now. With Gemini 2.5 Flash, you can combine different elements into the same scene with much more precision. So let's try it. And of course, you can use other models to compare if you want. I recorded this a little earlier and the AI world moves so fast. Since then, DeSign renamed its Gemini model to Nano Banana and also added C-Dream 4.0 for even more precise control. The chat editor now has frame control too, so you can set the aspect ratio before generating. With these updates, it's easier than ever to create consistent images of your influencer and product. So in the text prompt area, just type in your usual description, then specify things like The woman in image 1 is holding the product in image 2. This way, the models can know exactly which reference images to use. From there, add any extra details you want to refine the style and realism. Let's generate and see what we get. And here's the result. I think the result looks realistic and usable. Overall, the accuracy is really great. Now let's compare this with Flux Context that I generated here. Which one do you prefer? And if the hands looks unnatural, we can use Design Hand Repair Tool to fix them before moving to lip sync. So either way, both methods produce a convincing image of your influencer holding the product and ready to be animated for your UGC ad. Once we have the image of our influencer holding the product, so the next step is to animate it so the influencer can talk. To do this, we click open the lip sync panel. And while we are at the lip sync tool, we can upload a face image or a face video. For this one, we'll start with the image. Design gives you two options, the normal lip sync model or a pro lip sync, which has better movement and clarity. After uploading, you'll see the system will detect the face automatically, and it has a box that marks the face. But if it doesn't, you can also manually mark the face with this button. You can select up to two characters at the same time to lip sync. So if you have multiple characters in your image, you get to select which character to talk. But in our case, we'll just have one character for this one. Next step, we get to crop the frame and set the aspect ratio. Adjust the zoom and reposition the image. And in our character's timeline, we can pick a voice for the character to speak. For the voice, you have two options. We can use text-to-speech by typing the script and select a preset voice here. We can even choose different language, adjust the speed, and then generate the audio directly on Design. For this project, I'll use the voice I generated earlier in 11 Labs for more natural delivery. Once uploaded, the audio will appear on the timeline. And here's a quick tip. I would suggest to leave a small buffer at the start and end of the tracks, so the lip sync has time to form the first and last mouth shapes naturally, since it always wants to go back to the baseline of your image. We can also trim or adjust the audio length by dragging the end. And on the empty audio space, we can even add extra audio track if needed, just like how we add them before. When everything looks good, just click Generate and Design will create the lip sync video. And here's the result.
If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out. I was grinding in the gym every day and still felt stuck. No real progress, always tired. Then I tried Design Creatine Premium and total game changer.
The result looks pretty natural, but since we're starting from a still image, the movement is a little bit limited. To me, for longer videos, it's better to use the video input for lip sync. That way you can get more variety in terms of movement and dynamic gestures. Another thing to consider is also how the product is introduced. So I don't want the product to appear in the very first frame because it can feel too much like an ad. We'll reveal the product midway through the video. Let's just try that. To do this, we'll create two frames. One of the girl pointing at the camera as the start frame and one of her holding the product as the end frame. We can generate that first frame using an image model like Flux Context or the Gemini 2.5 Flash using the chat editor. Just by prompting naturally, such as remove the product and point her hand to the camera. And here is the result. And then in AI video, we'll select the Clean 2.1 Pro model, which now supports start and end frames. And the AI will link the first frame to the last one together into a cohesive video. For the start, we'll load the pointing image. And for the end, we will input the product holding image. In the text prompt, I'll describe a young woman talking directly to the camera with natural expressive hand gestures for a while. And then midway, she holds and displays a supplement bottle clearly to the lens, explaining its benefits in a friendly conversational way. From there, we can adjust the imaginary slider to balance relevancy and creativity. We don't really need sound effect here. And then we will set the duration to 10 seconds so we can allow enough speaking time. And then click generate. And here's the result. I think this video turned out really well. It's a solid base we can now animate with lip sync. To do that, we can click lip sync under the video. The video will then be loaded and we can select the face like before. Then we will get to the timeline interface. And then import our voice track. You can trim it depending on how much you want to sync. I uploaded the full track and wanted to edit it afterward, but if you plan the timing in advance, you can save credits by only generating the part that you want. In the timeline, you can play the video to line it up with the audio. And we can shift the track on the timeline to match the movements. If the audio runs longer than the video, for example, if you have like 15 seconds of audio on a 10 second clip, the video will loop the 5 seconds in the end. Once it's aligned, just click generate to produce the final lip sync video.
If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out. I was grinding in the gym every day and still felt stuck. No real progress, always tired. Then I tried D-Sign Creatine Premium and total game changer.
I think the result looks really natural. And the cool thing is with Gemini 2.5 Flash, you can also generate the same character in different scenarios, like working out in the gym or drinking water with the product on the table. This makes it easy to create lots of B-roll clips with your characters consistently and also the elements that you want to put. You can then animate those images the same way using AI videos and then layer them over your main talking video as B-rolls. So for editing, I use CapCut. I place the base talking videos on the timeline like this and then added the B-roll clips over it to cover transitions or the weird parts that you want to cover. Sometimes it does happen with lip sync. I also generated captions since short form content usually performed better with text on screen. And for TikTok style videos, adding something simple like a POV caption at the start is a great way to hook attention too. And here's the final result.
If you're not on creatine yet, you're honestly missing out. I was grinding in the gym every day and still felt stuck. Then I tried D-Sign Creatine Premium and total game changer. I've got way more energy, I recover faster, and I'm not dragging through my workouts anymore. It's literally like having a cheat code for gains. Once you use it, you can't imagine training without it. Don't wait around and waste more sessions. You'll thank yourself later. Grab yours now. I'll drop the link below.
Here's the total cost breakdown. 11 Labs free tier, Design Creator Plan for less than $20, and CapCut for free. With just a few AI tools, you can now create convincing UGC ads quickly, easily, and affordably. Try yourself with the link below and use my special code and let me know how it turns out. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next one. And also watch this video.